first of all, I want to make sure that people, if I go viral, I want people on my email list because that's my main channel. I know that if people, if someone is on my email list, I can build a relationship with them and I can then over time convert them into a customer. So that's the first thing. And secondly, people, like, with the exception, of course, but most of the time, people won't just share something unless it's super funny. But if it's about your business, it's usually not funny. Like, it's either sort of commercial or it's funny, right? But what I realized is that if you give someone an incentive, then all of a sudden they want to share. I mean, if I would ask you right now or whoever is watching, like, would you maybe share about my business on your Facebook profile? Most people say no. Some people may say yes, but they won't actually do it. However, if I would say, like, I'll give you $1,000 for it, which, by the way, I'm not, then a lot of people will say yes. Now, I'm not saying you should be giving away $1,000, but I'm saying that if you put the right bribe into place, people are, like, they're very way more likely, let's put it like that, to actually start sharing your message. And the first time I realized this actually was actually funny. What I did is I created an opt-in page so people could enter their name and email address in order to get some kind of a freebie, right? And then right after, I told them, like, hey, if you share my message on Facebook, then I'm going to give you an extra freebie, right? All you need to do is share on Facebook. And like hundreds of people did that, which was amazing. It was the first kind of lesson, first kind of experiment that I did. But it actually did not go viral, but it did spark my, like, basically my, like, what was possible if I could make this work even better, right? So then I started investigating deeper, like, what makes someone share. And I also realized that if you ask for someone to share on Facebook, that's what they'll do, right? But the problem is, like, oftentimes that's not actually what you want, because, like, if they could share it on a fake account, they could share it and then right after delete it. Or even if they would share it, for example, I'm from the Netherlands, and if I would share some kind of an English message, my friends would know it's not actually me, right? It's not, I'm not actually recommending it. It's just like a marketing message, right? And that's when Dropbox came along. Now, everyone knows Dropbox, but if you ask anyone on the street, how do you know Dropbox? Pretty much everyone's gonna say from a friend, from someone. Someone sent it to me. And the reason is because they were, like, so clever. They were super clever. They didn't just say, hey, go out and share Dropbox with your friends. No, they gave everyone, all of their users, their own unique invite link. So they could actually keep track if you actually referred a friend who actually signed up. And they said, like, hey, if you send this to your friends and one of your friends signs up, then we will give you extra storage. In other words, something of value in return for that. And now the goal isn't for people just to share, but they want to get as many people as possible to actually subscribe to, in this case, Dropbox. And when I saw that, I was like, huh, that's interesting. So this was like years back, right? So I started trying to hack something together with some developers and, like, made something real clunky and rough at that time, right? Where we could basically give everyone their own unique invite link. So first of all, people had to opt in. I wanted to have the email address because that's what drives my business. And then after, I gave everyone their own unique invite link so that, and I would then say, hey, like, if you get 5 of your friends to actually sign up, so their friends actually needed to sign up, it was all being tracked automatically, only then they would get access to this extra freebie that I had planned for them. And, like, what happened next was amazing. Like, people didn't just share it on Facebook, but they shared it on Twitter and on LinkedIn, like, all these other places, and not just once, but we also sent out some emails, like, hey, you know what, you're almost there, you already get 3 friends, but you only need 2 more. And people just kept on sharing until they actually got 5 people. And the best thing was that those 5 people, they started doing that again. And that's really when I sort of, like, discovered what I now know as what I call viral hacking. It's a good way to basically build up your email list by making sure people will promote your email list to all their friends and, you know, turning that into a viral loop.